Hi, my name is Sarah and I'm an online vegan fitness, nutrition, and mindset coach. I've been vegan for the past 9 years, but I've been practicing flexible dieting for the last 5. Flexible dieting is a tool that can help you understand nutrition, and it can also help you understand how to eat for your own specific fitness goals. Since I've been practicing flexible dieting for quite some time, it's easy for me to make meals and know exactly what the macronutrient ratio is going to look like. However, when you first start tracking your macronutrients, it can be really challenging to understand how to create meals that are satiating, but also meals that can actually help you hit your targets. This is why I'm about to show you a template on how to make high-protein, macro-friendly meals. Let's go. When you're planning out your meals, plan it around a protein source. Today I'm using this field roast sausage that is not super low in calories, but it is one of my favorite sources. And the macros are 8 grams of fat, 13 grams of carbs, and 25 grams of protein, so a total of 220 calories, which is pretty good. But if you wanted to use a lower calorie protein source, I would probably go for seitan because it does have the lowest carb, the lowest fat, and the highest protein source out of any vegan protein sources out there. And if you're trying to stay within a certain calorie range and you want to make your meals lower calorie, I would try and stay away from proteins that are breaded, proteins that are really high in carbs or really high in fats. So a lot of the burgers, a lot of the frozen fake meat do tend to have higher calories. Creating meals when you're tracking macronutrients is similar to a puzzle. If one or more ingredients are higher in fats or carbs, you want to combine them with other sources that are not. For example, if I'm using seitan as my primary protein source that is naturally low in fats and carbs, I can combine it with other sources that are more calorie dense. Next, we're gonna be using veggies for macronutrients and volume. I'm gonna be using zucchini, these frozen mixed veggies, and broccoli. And I'm also gonna be using these mushrooms that I forgot I had and some arugula for greens. This is how you create that volume that's gonna keep you satiated. Veggies are extremely low in calories, so you can pretty much add as many as you want. And choosing the ones that are also high in protein is just gonna make it easier for you to hit your protein goals. For example, like broccoli. Mistake that I see a lot of people make when they're trying to lose weight and they're trying to change their diet is that they create low calorie meals that are really low in protein and low in fats, which is not a great idea because protein and fats are the most satiating macronutrients. So you always wanna make sure that you do have some protein and fats in your meals. For this meal, I'm not gonna be adding any fats because the sausage already does have some fat. If you're opting for a protein source that already has fat, you don't necessarily need to add additional fat if you're trying to keep your calories on the lower end. Next, we're doing a carb source, which is cooked quinoa. And if you are trying to eat this meal even lower calories, you can skip the carb source. This is why tracking can be such an amazing tool, because it can help you understand what are the calories, what are the fats, what are the carbs, what are the proteins that I need on a daily basis, and you can create your meals around that versus trying to figure out, oh, should I have carbs now? Should I have fats in this? How much protein I need? How many calories does this have? All those questions get answered when you learn about tracking your food intake. Lastly, I'm gonna be adding what I like to call a fun add-on. So this is just some type of flavoring, a sauce, a dressing, something that can make your meal taste better. I'm gonna be using reduced sodium soy sauce and nutritional yeast. Nutritional yeast is really high in protein. It adds that cheesy, nutty flavor, and soy sauce is low in calories and has a gram of protein per tablespoon. Thank you. giant bowl that is high in protein, high in micronutrients. We have some carbs, we have some fats, and I'm gonna put the calories in the exact ingredients right here. Someone says that this is not a low calorie meal because it has more than 400 calories. It is. I've seen a lot of videos and posts about low calorie meals that are under 200 calories, and that is not a meal, that is a snack. I hope you got some value from this video. Please let me know if there's anything specific that you would like to see next. And if you're interested in more high protein meals, check out my new vegan cookbook that has 20 high protein vegan meals. Also, I'd really appreciate it if you liked this video and left a comment. If you did receive any value from it, it really helps grow my channel. And I will see you in the next video.